MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's on to Game 5 of the National League Championship Series between the LA Dodgers and the San Diego Padres. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Danny, this is still anyone's series here as we get ready for Game 5.
Well, they're down 3-1, so it's do-or-die time now. That's not a good place to be, obviously, but we do see some teams play their best when their backs are up against the ropes. The key is to just take it one game at a time and not worry about how many more wins you need.
Set for what should be a good one. Lineups and first pitch are next. Chris Paddock has the ball for the fifth game of the series. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Lots of potential in this right arm here in Chris Paddock. Big, strong guy, throws good. 94 to 97 miles an hour. Live fastball, he'll throw it up in the zone. He'll throw an occasional two-seam fastball down in the zone also. Needs to work a little bit more on his secondary pitches. One of the keys for Chris Paddock, getting ahead strike one so he can use that array of off-speed pitches.
This one up. Hosmer is under it. One away. So one out and nobody aboard. And striding to the plate will be Corey Seager. Bases are empty. One man out. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Grisham is there now, and he has it, two gone. So the bases are empty with two gone now, and that'll bring up the third baseman, Justin Turner. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Hit high and deep to right center. Back goes Grisham. He makes the catch. What a play on the run to end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. Dodgers scoreless, Padres coming to bat. It's the battle for Southern California bragging rights, and it's on the show. David Price will do the pitching with a trip to the World Series on the table. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, Matt, we're going to get a chance to look at a good veteran pitcher here. This guy's been around the block a few times, but one of the things he does, he still competes at a high level, and he's never stopped trying to learn how to be a good pitcher.
So stepping in is Trent Grisham. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Here now the 2-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base, and that's just what they did right there. Big strikeout, keep that guy off the base path.
In now, Fernando Tatis Jr. Down low, two balls and a strike. One out, nobody on. Easy there, big fella.
Two,
two and two.
Two strikes.
Push to the right side. A leap, but he can't bring it down. Base hit.
You know, it's funny. The first two strikes are for the fans. You're trying to put balls that in the seats right there. With the two strikes, it's for the team. You got to shorten up and find a way. And that's exactly what he did right there. Soft liner into right field for a base hit.
Into the box, Manny Machado. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball. Tatis, a runner at first with one gone in the inning. And now they've got him picked off. And they got him at second base on a good, smart play that time.
Well, that's not a good look. No one likes getting picked off, but it's especially bad when it's your team's first hit. It's kind of deflating.
Price into his motion. Here's the 2-1. He sends it out to left field. Well hit. Gone! It's a solo home run off the bat of Manny Machado. And the Padres bust out in front 1-0.
People always wonder why some players make so much money, and there's your answer. The great ones find a way to rise to the occasion, even, and he did right there.
At the plate, Eric Hosmer. Down the first baseline. Fielded cleanly, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. But they're off to a good start as they pick up a run on this solo shot. Second inning coming up. It's 1-0 San Diego. Second inning set to go. And here comes Cody Bellinger. Trying to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. And he fouls this one off. Another try at 2-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And that misses for ball four. So it's a leadoff walk here to start the second.
And I'm sure the manager is just fine with that. I mean, it's better to battle a slugger like that to the end and end up walking him than serving one up where he can really hurt you.
Here now is Will Smith. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. Chopped weakly to the left. Again, a 1-2. Pitch is way outside, and that's straight to the backstop. And forget about the double play now, as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch.
Well, now might be a good time to make a visit to the mound. Your pitcher walks the first batter and allows him to get into scoring position with the wild pitch. Got to settle him down and make sure everything's all right physically.
And he struck him out. Stepping up is Max Muncy, trying here to plate the tying run from second. Here now the 2-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. And with two away, here's a look at our updated playoff bracket. And the question on everyone's mind is, will we be able to punch our first ticket to the World Series after tonight's ballgame? Striding in is A.J. Pollock. The base knock to the outfield could score the tying run from second. Ready with the 1-1.
Oh,
job on those last two pitches of varying speeds. Gave him a hard fastball, and then he locked him up with a changeup.
The 2-2. Got him swinging. Made him chase outside the zone that time, and that puts an end to the inning. Dodgers lead one. They still trail 1-0. Last half of the second set to go, and up next it'll be the outfielder Tommy Pham. Here comes the 1-2. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Man, I love watching a pitcher that just rears back and blows smoke by a guy at the letters. That's the ultimate challenge pitching. For me personally, watching hitters swing and miss, man, that's a sight of beauty.
Into the box now, Will Myers. Low and inside with the breaking ball as that causes him to back up a bit. Here's a topper fouled off to the right, and that leaving the count at 2-2.
He's got that certainly timed up now. I'd be shocked if the pitcher goes to the well three times in a row with off speed.
Here now the 2-2. Jake Cronenworth waits on deck. Three-two pitch. Hit out towards second. And into center field as he's aboard with a one-out single.
Sometimes you get lucky in this game. I don't think pitch recognition wise he would choose to swing at that exact pitch. But you know what? Sometimes result is the only thing that matters.
At the plate now, Jake Cronenworth. And he's keeping it down here, and that's a called strike two.
Well, they've really had an answer for keeping him in check in this series. He's offered very little resistance with the bat in his hand so far.
Here comes the 1-2. Pitch outside, the throw. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. Jurickson Profar will come on now to replace him as he's in to pinch run following the injury. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Pollock has a read on it. He's got it, and there are two down now. And this throw gets away from him. So a runner in scoring position with two men gone, and that brings up Austin Nola. Padres an early 1-0 lead here in the second. He's falling behind now, 3-1.
Here's the game within the game. You have a better matchup on deck. You've got a 3-1 count in this situation. Don't be afraid to put him on base and attack the next guy.
The 3-1 pitch. That finds the zone, a called strike.
You know he wants to end this inning right here on 3-2, but I don't think we'll see him lay one in on the next pitch there with a base open to work with.
He loses him on ball four.
That walk is going to feel extra frustrating for this pitcher. Not only do you never really want to walk the number eight hitter, but it's also going to let the pitcher hit this inning instead of forcing him to lead off the next one.
A 1-1 pitch. Hit in the air out to right. That's giving chase. He's got it. A great running. That'll retire the side. Padres leave a pair. We play two innings. It's 1-0. Jurickson Profar will stick around as he'll take over in right field.
Now playing right field. Number 10.
Top of the third set to get underway. And up next will be Gavin Lux. Now the 1-1 pitch. Misses ball two.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
3-1 to him now. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike.
Three ball, two strikes.
Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. And he lays off there. Ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three.
They haven't been able to register a hit against this guy, but at least they have a base runner here. We'll see if that leads to something.
So now the pitcher, David Price. This is a textbook sacrifice situation, so let's see if that's the call. Squaring to bunt, but this is a foul ball. And he's bunting with two strikes, but can't connect. Still wasted at bat there. Here's Mookie Betts, 0-for-1 here in the early going. Lux leads off first with one away. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2.
Ugh, is that ugly? You could probably throw anything out there to this guy. He'd swing at the rosin bag if you throw it up there.
Here's the 1-2. Runners on the move for second. Pitch is high. The throw. Not in time as he steals second. The Dodgers have yet to break into the hit column here. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now. 3-2. Hit on the ground to third. Machado is there, and that's the second out. Two out, runner in scoring position at second. And up next, the former All-Star shortstop, Corey Seager. Ready with the 1-1.
Well, you can see here, this has been a steady diet of off-speed pitches, and what has it gotten him? Not a whole lot, as he's fallen behind in the count. 3 balls and 1 strike.
Now Corey with a swing and a deep drive to right. And out of here, and I mean by plenty. That ball was crushed. So it's a 2-run homer for Corey Seager. His 4th long ball of this series, and the Dodgers move out in front. It's 2-1.
Hey, that's the price you pay right there when you try and sneak a fastball past this guy. Power hitter, and every power hitter in the league knows you got to start with the numero uno, number one, man. You got to get on the heater and adjust to everything else, and he did just that.
Stepping in now, Justin Turner. Turner in front at 3 balls and a strike.
Boy, his pitch count has really spiked here in this inning. He's up to over 50 already.
The 3-1. Takes a strike for a full count now, 3-2.
Hey, there aren't too many power hitters in the game that would let that pitch go by.
Drilled right back up the middle. Reined in. Throw to first with time to spare, and the side is retired. But the Dodgers do strike for two coming on this two-run home run. We played 2.5, 2-1 Los Angeles. Bottom of the third now, and at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Trent Grisham. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. Nearly a big fly to start the inning, instead of foul ball.
Huge swing of the bat right there, just hooking foul. Would have tied the game. I know there's still a lot of game left, but that was potentially a huge momentum swing there. Gonna have to find a way to refocus and continue this at bat.
Digging in now for San Diego, Fernando Tatis Jr. He singled in his first AB. And that's on the outside corner, 1-2. A 2-1 score here as we play inning number 3. Fouled away. Swing and a ball hit on the ground. Another 1-2 delivery. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone to protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
In now, Manny Machado. And it's 2 balls and 2 strikes now. 2 out, nobody on. Swing and a miss, and that's out number 3. Padres down in order. They still trail it here, 2-1. Start of the fourth upcoming, but first, Heidi Watney is standing by with a report.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far, and flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. It's still pretty early in the game, but they've seen a lot of pitches already, and he thinks the 2 runs they've pushed across so far is just the beginning, given the quality of the at-bats they're putting together.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Set for the start of the inning, and standing in the outfielder, Cody Bellinger. Here's the 1-1 delivery. And he takes ball 2, and it's 2-1.
Hasn't seen a heater yet in this at bat. One might be coming right here.
Him up. And he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number 1. One gone now in the Dodger fourth, and that brings up Will Smith. Swing and a liner toward the gap in left center. Grisham is there to take it, and that's the second out of the inning.
He got that one pretty good. It just didn't have the right launch angle to carry over the outfielder's head. Small difference where the ball hit the bat could have made all the difference.
To the plate now, Max Muncy. Bouncer to the left side, and he whiffs on it as this ball's right under his glove.
Yeah, I'm not sure. This ball might have caught him in between hops. He looked unsure which way to turn his glove, and the next thing you know, it's by him.
So now to the plate,
A.J. Pollock.
I got the count.
One changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. One and two now. Oh, and they pulled the string on a good changeup there as he swings and misses, and he's set down on strikes for the second time tonight. One left for L.A. They still lead it 2-1. Just about set to go for the last of the fourth, but before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, I talked with San Diego's manager during the inning break about the Padres' offensive production to this point. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Bottom of the inning now, and standing in, here's the first baseman, Eric Hosmer. Fouled off. Now another 1-2.
Outside, that's the ball.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4, 5, and 6 right here.
High in the air out to center field. Bellinger's under it. One down. No one on with one down. And up next, it'll be the outfielder, Tommy Pham. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Scooped up on the first, and the price is right here, two away. So two are gone in the Padre fourth, and Jurickson Profar will be the next to bat. One run on three hits and one error for the Padres so far. On the ground to the right side. And this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single.
The pitcher got the result he was looking for. Change up down in the zone, gets him to hit it on the ground, but obviously the result wasn't what he wanted.
Into the box now, Jake Cronenworth. And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
Well, he made quick work of the first two guys this half inning, getting two quick outs, but then he gives up a base hit and now the walk. We'll see if he has it in him to draw the line in the sand and get out of this.
Fouled away. Payoff pitch on its way. And another foul ball. And a half-hearted swing there as they tie him up inside for the third strike, and the inning is over. Padres leave a pair. They're down 2-1. All ready to go in the top of the fifth. And bring in the second baseman, Gavin Lux. The 1-2 pitch. Swing and a miss, and he'll start the fifth the same way he ended the fourth, with a punch out, one away.
This is why it's so hard to be successful as a hitter when you fall behind in the count. One and two, you're probably expecting some sort of off-speed pitches, but when the pitcher offers up a good, hard fastball, it's pretty hard to adjust and catch up to it.
At the plate now, David Price. And this will be fouled away. Here comes the 1-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him.
Two up, two down on strikes in this inning. He looks really sharp out there, guys.
Right fielder, Mookie Betts.
Standing in now, Mookie Betts. There's a drive high in the air and deep to left center field. Out of here, into the visitor's bullpen. A solo home run there for Mookie, and it gives the Dodgers a 3-1 lead.
No surprise with that swing of the bat. This guy is simply one of the best in the game right now. There's not too many guys that take a beautiful hack like that in the league.
At the plate, Corey Seager. Here is a ground ball now for the shortstop to the right of second. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. But the Dodgers add on courtesy of this solo home run. Middle of the night here in Arlington. It's 3-1 LA. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and that'll bring up the pitcher, Chris Paddock.
Offense needs to get going right here. You want to try and tighten up this game a little bit before it starts to get into that territory where you're going to start seeing the back end of each bullpen.
Ball taken there, 2-1 now. Lays off the changeup, and he's ahead in the count now, 3-1. Trent Grisham will be next. The 3-1 pitch. Swung on and missed, and that's a full count now, 3 balls and 2 strikes.
Oh, man, was that a hack. He's trying to create his own run support with a swing like that.
Swing and a liner. And the pitcher's got himself a base hit.
Hey, that's a win-win right there. Solid AB by the pitcher after battling, making this pitcher work, and executing and getting a result. Job well done.
To the plate now, Trent Grisham. On a line to shortstop. One out, runner at first. And that'll bring up Fernando Tatis Jr. Paddock, base runner at first with one out. Now Price misses here on 2-2, and he runs it full, 3 balls and 2 strikes.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
Now the payoff pitch home. High and deep down the left field line. And that will end up a foul ball. The 3-2 one more time. Line to the right side. In there, a base hit. The hold at second, and there are two aboard now.
Hey, just a nice piece of hitting right there. He's able to keep his hands inside that ball, stay square as long as possible, and feed it into the opposite field for a base hit.
Now here's the Dodgers skipper up out of the dugout on his way to the mound, and he's going to come get his starter here, so that'll be all this evening for David Price. So he'll head to the dugout after working just 4 1/3, not enough to qualify for the victory, as his bullpen will have to go a long way to hang on to the lead. Tony Gonsolin takes the mound to try to get out of this mess. There are two on with only one away. In now, Manny Machado. Looked like ball four there, but instead it's 3-2 now.
What I love right there is just the freedom in that hack. He ain't trying to do anything but hit the baseball as far as he can.
3-2 pitch. Hit in the air toward the gap in right center. Betts on the run, but he can't get there, and this might tie up the game. And they'll hold that runner at third as everybody moves up a base, and they're loaded with one away.
Boy, that's a bullet right there. You're thinking this is extra bases off the bat, but a terrific play by the outfielder.
Yeah, and I thought he was hanging out watching himself and digging what he had just done, but that's not the case. He was busting it out of the box. Nice play by the defender to get that ball in, hold him to a single.
First baseman Eric Hosmer is in. And guys, this is clearly one of the bigger at-bats of the ballgame so far.
Yeah, Matt, bases loaded. They're looking to finally get that clutch hit that's kind of been elusive all day. They've had some hits, but they just haven't hit when it mattered.
3-1 our score as we play inning number 5. Hit hard up the middle. And that's through into center field. Base hit. One run scored. And he's safe.
Hey, after being down by two, getting into the middle of this one, that's a huge base hit right there, Nero. Big two RBI move.
Yeah, down by two right there, able to come through for the team, and we probably got an exciting finish on that.
Into the box, Tommy Pham. Oh, and there's a drive to deep left center. You can pretty much forget about this one. This is way out of here. So a 3-run shot to left center, and it's now 6-3.
Going to see a pitch in the zone, but he could not have hoped for a better pitch to drive. All aboard the RBI train.
Victor Gonzalez, a lefty standing 6 foot even, takes over the pitching duties here. So now to the plate, Jurickson Profar. Count is 1-2 now. Into the windup and the pitch.
Two balls, two strikes.
And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away.
Hey, I'm not sure what he was sitting on right there. He might have been sitting on an off-speed pitch, but instead, he gets the fastball way late. Had no chance to put that ball in play.
At the plate now, Jake Cronenworth. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. But the big blow of the inning comes right here, a 3-run home run. through five innings. As they've doubled up now, it's 6-3. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and digging in at the plate will be Justin Turner. Now the 1-1 pitch.
2-1-1
Hey, this is a real pesky hitter right here. As a pitcher, you really like to keep this guy off the bases. This is a guy that kind of sets the tables for big innings.
2-2. Two balls, two strikes, a crucial count for both pitcher and hitter. So, Dan, what was your approach on the mound in that count? Do you still pitch for the strikeout here?
Action pitch right here, 2-2. Last thing you want to do is to fall behind and count 3-2.
Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth. So here's the cleanup hitter, Cody Bellinger, popped into foul ground his last time up.
Yeah, Matt, he's got to make an adjustment right here. His swing definitely broke down, dropped his back shoulder, and thus the result was a terrible pop-up foul.
That's in there on the outer half, 1-2 now. And he struck him out, and that's 8 strikeouts thus far.
I think we're starting to see the frustration mount from this offense. It's been a pretty dominant performance on the mound, and these hitters have had no answer for anything he's throwing up there. That will wear on you if it lasts throughout most of the game like it has here.
Standing in now, Will Smith. And he'll come back with one in third as the count moves to 2-1 now. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. The 2-1. Into right field, that's a base hit. Through first and hustling for second. And he'll make it to second base now with two gone.
When you're struggling as a team to put the ball in play, every base hit is welcome, but a double will really help wake everyone up. That's just their third hit of the game, but it's a good one.
Stepping in now, Max Muncy. Swing and a miss there, and it's 2-2. Fastball well outside.
Some pitchers fall into the trap of giving in on 3-2 because they don't want to walk the guy. But with the base open, it's not the end of the world if you do. You still need to make a quality pitch.
Payoff pitch on its way. In the air, down the line and left. Left fielder giving chase. And he makes the catch in the corner. Two out double, left stranded. More on tap from game 5 after this. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And next to hit is the catcher, Austin Nova. This one's outside, quite a bit off the plate that time. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Smoked on the ground, left side. A diving try, but it's through into the outfield.
Hey, some guys can handle the postseason lights, and this is obviously one of them. Another base hit leading off for the boys. This guy's had a monster postseason so far.
Victor Caratini
will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 17, Victor Caratini.
Working for the punch out and the offering. ball two with a sinker that runs off the inside. High in the air down the right field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one.
That was some nice execution on that pitch. Spotted it nicely down around the bottom of the zone. And when you do that, especially with two strikes, not a lot of guys are going to hurt you. You're going to get a lot of ground balls and swings and misses down there.
So a runner at first now with one away, and that brings up Trent Grisham. Nola, a runner at first with one gone in the inning. Swing and a miss. Good sinking action there. One and two.
Yeah, guys, he's got so much respect for this guy's fastball. You could tell he was out in front on that slider. I think he goes to the well one more time with that pitch.
Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone. That's back-to-back strikeouts now as they've been unable to advance that leadoff single into scoring position.
Yeah, clearly no problems working out of the stretch right now, Matt. He's taking control this inning after giving up that hit. Now we'll see if he can finish it off strong as well.
At the plate, Fernando Tatis Jr. And there's ball two now. Drilled on the ground to short. Right to him. On to second for the force out, and the side is retired. So a good bounce back inning here after the 5-run outburst last time around. Game five moves to the 7th inning now. It's the Padres 6 and the Dodgers 3. Tim Hill is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Number 25. Jared Hill.
At the plate now is A.J. Pollock. He started out the evening 0 for 2 so far. He dives. Did he catch that? He did. What a play there for the first down.
Good contact to start out the inning. Thought he might be on base with some sort of a hit, but it hung up there too long. Just unlucky that time.
One gone now in the LA 7th, and up next will be Gavin Lux. Now the 2-1 pitch is taken. Ball three. Bases are empty. One man out. Opposite field to left. And that's into the outfield for a one out hit.
Think there's any justice in the game, watch those two at bats. Now both of them hit on the absolute screws. One's right at one guy, and then one's a single. Go figure.
Chris Taylor come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Number three. Taylor.
The bag and dive, but he's back. Now the 1-1 pitch. High in the air down the right field line. There to play it is Profar, and there are two away. So it's a runner at first with two men out. And up next, one of the terrific talents in the game, Mookie Betts. Still 2-2. Hit high and deep out to straightaway left. Racing back the left fielder. And that one is gone on a two-strike count with two away in the inning. Two runs on the board after the home run by Mookie Betts. His second of the game, and this will make things interesting at this point. It's now a 6-5 game. Now, Corey Seager. Liner in there for a base hit.
Now batting, the third baseman, Justin.
Into the box now, Justin Turner. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2.
Two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Count remains full. Seager leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Swing and a miss on a ball way outside the strike zone, and the inning is over. But two come across to score in the inning courtesy of this two-run home run. Bottom of the seventh inning coming up. Get up and stretch. It's the Padres 6 and the Dodgers 5. Corey Knebel gets the call from the pen to take the ball for the home seventh.
Number 46, Corey Knebel.
Into the box, Manny Machado singled in his last at bat. Here's the 1-1 delivery.
Ball.
This is one of my biggest pet peeves in the game, when guys get count leverage and take fastballs. It's a game of fastballs. You calibrate everything off the heater. Surprising take right there.
Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at bat going. Hit well towards the hole. And there's a base hit, so a chance for some insurance here to start out the home half of the seventh.
Yeah, that hard hit single right there, that's clean. 3-for-4, he's looking locked in.
Aaron Hosmer.
At the plate now, Aaron Hosmer lifted down the line in left. And foul. Nobody out, runner on first. Shatters the bat as this is hit to third. He's got it. Throw won't get him.
You know, D-Lo, sometimes one of your best friends and your own teammates right there. Good hustle from first base to beat that throw to second. And guess what? He bought his battery, made a knock.
Yeah, he definitely bought him a knock. You know what else he's going to buy him? He's going to buy him dinner on the road at some point, because that's some significant hustle right there. It was a nice play. The internal clock of the defender thought he still had a chance at second. Wasn't meant to be.
A 1-2. High in the air out towards shallow right. That's coming on. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning.
Now batting, right fielder.
Dirksen Profar digs in next. He's one for two in this one. And this one's in the dirt. The runners will hold tight, but it's a full count now, 3-2. Looking for the K. Here's the pitch.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
And he looks at one that misses, and that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches as he toughs out a walk.
Oh, that's a walk that could really change the complexion of the game. With the bases loaded, if he gives up a base hit right here, it could get real ugly.
Your attention, please.
So with a left-handed hitter waiting, they'll go to their own left-hander out of the bullpen. Jake Cronenworth will be the first to meet him here, and he'll do so in an enviable situation indeed. Bases loaded and only one out now.
It often becomes harder to hit the zone when the pressure starts to heat up.
Bases are loaded with only one out. All even now, 2-2. From the belt, the pitch. And fouls this one off.
Not surprised he's late on a heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch. Wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
And here look at a called third strike. Oh, and a big one there as the bases stay loaded. And there are two gone now.
Up next,
next it'll be Austin Nova. He's looking to deliver here with the bases loaded and two out in the inning. Machado at third, Hosmer on second, Profar on at first with two down. Now a ball hit in the air, and this looks like it'll get him out of it. Pollard is there as he makes the catch, and they'll tightrope out of danger as he strands the bases loaded. Pods leave them loaded as it remains a 6-5 ball game. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Emilio Pagan will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Tucapita Marcano is into the ballgame as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. Cody Bellinger at the plate now. Strike 1-2. As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan, D'Lo, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage. Yeah, you know, D'Lo, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
Plate now, Will Smith. Swung on in the dirt, strike three. And he makes the throw to first. Smith is retired, two down now.
You know, professional catchers make those plays look easy most of the time, but that was a big play that shouldn't go unnoticed. Had he found a way on, he would have represented a tying run, so
That was a nice job there to make sure that strikeout didn't get wasted.
Into the box, Max Muncy. Not quick enough that time, and he's lucky to get another chance. Count remains full. Once again, a 3-2. And he struck him out. So a fine inning here as he strikes out the side in order. Pure dominance on the mound as he strikes out the side in order. More coming up from Game 5 after this. On to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 44, Tommy Haley.
Now at the plate, Tucapita Marcano. And he's getting his first plate appearance here in the eighth after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. And he'll come back with one in the third as the count moves to 2-1 now. Fastball, and looks like they're pinching him a bit here. It's 3-1.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
And this is taken here for ball four. So the leadoff man's on base to kick off the home eighth.
That is not the way he wanted to start off this half inning. It's one thing to walk the leadoff hitter, but it's even more painful when the leadoff hitter is an absolute burner and he can really wreak some havoc on the bases.
And the hit will be Trent Grisham, struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. The 2-1 home is swung on and missed, and that's strike two. Now the Dodgers get a right-hander up and throwing in their bullpen. A runner at first with no outs here. Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game. What's your take on all the strikeouts we see in the game today, Dan? That was his third tonight, and it seems we're seeing that a lot more these days.
Yeah, Matt, there's been a real change in philosophy as far as hitting in baseball today. A lot of guys think now that an out is an out, a strikeout is just as good as a regular out, but we're seeing strikeouts at an alarming rate in baseball right now.
At the plate, Fernando Tatis Jr. The 2-1. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact. In the on-deck circle is Manny Machado. He'll bat next. Marcano stands at first with one out. Fouled away. The next 3-2. Again, he sends it out of play. Another payoff pitch. Hit hard back up the middle. A bare hand for one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Padres go down quietly. They lead it, however, it's 6-5. Clint Pomeranz comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth. Set to start the ninth in this one, and standing in is the veteran outfielder, A.J. Pollock. The 2-1 home. will get over the wall down the line out there for a ground rule double.
Well, that will bring a smile to a manager's face every single time. First hitter of the inning just squares it up and bounces it over the fence. Even if it stays in the yard, that's a double either way.
So now to the plate, Gavin Lux fouled off. Two is the cut fastball, but he holds back. Two and two. One run game here in the top of the ninth. Skied down the left field line. Left fielder is on the move. The catch is made, and the tying run is going to tag from second. And he is in there at third as the possible tying run. Edwin Rios will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line. And he struck him out. And wouldn't this be something if he could work out of this with that one-run lead still in check? Mookie Betts stands in looking for home run number three right here as you see what he's done so far in this one.
Final run score for our ball game tonight. For the victorious San Diego Padres, 6 runs on 12 hits, 1 error, they left 9 men on base.